and will cover the system design for 5 artificial processes, beginning with 2 artificial pancreas designs. These systems are multi-input, multi-output systems. For the first artificial pancreas, the inputs to the system are the blood levels of glucose and insulin, and the outputs were the amount of these hormones delivered. The model for the system is shown with a measurement unit, control unit, and an infusion unit. A second artificial pancreas design was developed and took into account additional variables such as the stress level, sleep, and physical activities of the patient. The model for the artificial pancreas system can be seen here and contains 2 separate feedback loops for the system. The next category of systems we will look at are prosthetics, also known as artificial limbs. These devices require advanced control systems ranging from simply mechanical or simply electrical to brain-machine interface designs. Devices that are brain-controlled can also be called myoelectric. An example of one such control system is shown here. Compare here a mechanically controlled prosthetic arm from 1910 to a modern-day brain-controlled prosthetic arm from 2014. Next system we will discuss is a temperature-controlled catheter design. The human body has an effective means for temperature regulation through the hypothalamus, maintaining at 37 degrees Celsius. After brain death, the system is no longer functioning, and hypothermia, or when the body temperature drops below 35 degrees Celsius, may set in. For successful organ donation to occur, the proper body temperature must be maintained after brain death. The final design to consider is a respiratory system model. An artificial respiratory system must exchange gases such as carbon dioxide and oxygen in correct balance, while requiring the minimal amount of effort from the user. A model designed to minimize the work of breathing is shown here.